youngsters under the age of 30, I want to hear your energy, okay? Youngsters under the age of 30, give me a loud cheer. This is the sound of denial. People over the age of 30, give me a loud cheer. This is the sound of reality. Okay, married people, give me a cheer. That is the sound of pain. I'm in my mid-30s and I'm married, so my dunya mein dard aur reality. But I never thought, you know, being in my mid-30s, I would have a generation gap with these youngsters who screamed in the beginning, right? Like, they're just few years younger to me. I can't even speak the same language they speak. You know, when I go to the hospital, I'm talking to a PG or an intern, bro, what's up, bro? Bro, what, bro? Someone from behind me, like, who is it? Bro, I, bro. What happened to your eye, bro? Bro, I, bro. Like, who's with you? Bro, bro, bro. Team, bro. And it makes sense. So I can't even communicate. And you know, if I go and do some comedy show and go play the younger generation, I mean, my generation from 80s, 90s, you know how they encourage us, hey, do a good job. At the most, break a leg. But today's generation, these kids, kill him, bro. Destroy, bro. Chill, they go farther. I'm like, and I don't want to have this disconnect, right? So one day I did a search with my boss, asked Jagdish, how was the case? I said, bro, kill it, bro. Destroy it, bro. He wanted to kill and destroy me after that. Yo, patient ke saamne nahi kar sakta na. Patient OT table ke gala baar wait kar raha. Apna mere bhauji pe surgery kiya, kaisa hua khalas. Aisa nahi kar sakta. That's why I'm doing comedy for security reasons. I studied in a small medical college in Tumkur. You know of Tumkur? It's a city. You know Tumkur? You've heard of it. So I studied there, did my internship from there. After that, I moved into St. John's Medical College and did my ENT over there. And that's when, you know, I realized how technology, actually, we're talking about technology, right? How it affects doctors. We don't think of it. Because nowadays there's an app for everything, you know, there's an app for everything. I once thought, what is there an app not for? And I found an app for that. Uska naam tha apne app bhool lo. You get an app for everything, right? And these technologies, apps, you know, technology experts make it. And they make it for a particular need. Like, any engineers say, give me a cheer? Engineering college, man, they don't get into relationships very soon. So, ye log banate hain apps like Tinder. Because that is the problem they face, right? And you know how it affects a doctor like me, right? I have friends, and you know, how many of you have friends now? Give me a cheer. They're denied by the reality. You know, what friend now? Have you heard the saying, friend in need is a friend indeed? You are in that need because of that friend's need. Ye pura khatam karne ko nahi pata. And friends have this knack of giving a very bad advice but sounding very intelligent. So my friend told me, Jagdish, you have to modernize yourself. Tell your name is old and you know, your content is not connecting to youngsters. Do some new things. I'm like, what? Then Tinder, then Tinder. What's I'm married, I have a 3-year-old child. If I go on Tinder, I'll actually meet Tinder. But socha dost hai to maat maan lete. So I go on Tinder. Suddenly I get a match in 5 minutes. Girl is like, what's a doctor doing on Tinder? My doctor's a very insane. Maybe zindagi explore kar sakta ho, meri zarurat hai. So what kind of doctor are you? I said ENT. Oh, ear, nose, throat, my favorite. You know, jab main nahane jaati hu, mera kaan band ho jata hai. I'm like, then it must be wax and water is entering inside. Like, sorry, wax, ear drops, 3 drops in the morning, 3 drops in the night. Review with me in the OPD for flushing after 1 week. Unmatched. Consultations make it free. And then people make these apps like Practo Library that connect doctors and patients together, right? And you know, we get onto those platforms. One day I had an appointment with this patient called Shweta, right? And she wrote to me saying, doctor, can I reschedule my appointment from 6:30 to 7 o'clock? I'm like, sure, Shweta, you are my only patient. For the last 1 week. And there's a lot of traffic in Bangalore. You say 7 o'clock, no, she's up, there's a little while. She sends back to me 3 kisses. 2 hearts. 4 faces with the heart wala smiley. I'm like, I said,
Then I look at my over smartphone, auto-corrected Shweta to Sweetheart.
Consultation by dating or dating by consultation.
This is how tech affects doctors like us, you know.
And I was a postgraduate student in St. John's, right? As we teach, you know, seniors like juniors PG. It's a very common thing. I was supposed to go to a rural place. We used to go to a rural place called Mugloor to do rural camps, right? And we were examining a patient's throat. We had a, you know, a patient who had some throat issue. And you know, today, any ENTs here in the room? Give me a chair. Any ENT?
You're the only one.
I'm the only one, okay. Even today, you know, how you examine the throat, we basically make the patient sit down, okay? And we ask them to open the mouth, and we say, Zuma Kesari. Dane 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 Kesari. Nice Manik Chand Biff is coming, you know. We hold the, you know, if you are lucky, we have a glove, which is a bear, and we hold that wrinkly tongue, red color one. And then you have to put a mirror, a long mirror, anchor at a particular this thing, put it all the way in the back, with that Manik Chand Biff coming in, everything fogging that mirror, right? And if that is not enough, there is a bullseye lamp that comes from behind your shoulder. That light has to reflect in the right angle, and then you look at the voice box, and almost like you skip a beat when you see it. It's easier to see the moon in Kapachot than to see that quick vocal cord through that reflection of the small fogging mirror of manager. Right? Or like, how do you make a diagnosis with that, right? So we usually make sounds like they're understanding everything. Right? And I'm doing this, and my senior, you know, how he wants to trouble me is basically, he was seeing another case and he's like, Jagdish, come here, you tell me your findings in this patient. So I take the same hand, hold the tongue. You know, this one was having some vodka, so I was like, okay, naya brand hai, market. And I put the mirror inside, mujhe kuch samajh nahi aata. But my colleagues have told me, whenever your senior asks something, tell them the most safest answer. Which I did. I told sir, he's normal. Upar wala balance kar leta hai. He's like, thank God you could make out something, I couldn't make out anything myself. And that is why the first time fear struck me is like both him and I, ghar se baal kaat ke kapda pehna rakhe hum 70 km jaate hain aur humko kuch pata nahi hum kar kya rahe hain. And these farmers and daily wagerers, they leave half their day of work and they come over here and they are like, we are having some problem in our throat aur hum log koi manik chand dukha wagar kar rahe and I'm not able to see anything. And that's why, you know, Swadesh movie had released and I was like, you know, mera andar ka wo kuch karna hai desh ke liye. And with that Manik Chand effect, I did something which most people would not do. I went back to my hospital and I met my boss. He was very, very senior, and as most bosses, very angry. Doctor called Dr. Rami Nair. I have his permission to use his name. Right? And I went and told him, sir, we go to these villages, rural areas, mirror use kar raha hu, ghanta samajh mein nahi aa raha. Kya hai problem hai kahin? Okay? Idhar patient aata hai. We have this 3D endoscopy system, 3 lakh, you know, 3-chip camera. When you can see the cancer from far away. Why can't we have such a system like this in a rural place where you can actually pick these early stages? Early stage disease come there. Why are we having this here? And there we are struggling with mirrors. And it was the end of the OPD. He looks down like this. He's like, Jagdish, tu bhokne wala kutta hai ki kaatne wala kutta hai? I'm like, off of syllabus question. But this is a thesis guide, so I have to answer. So I said, you know, bhokne wala kutta achha nahi hota. Sir, main kaatne wala kutta. So he looks at me and says, "Tu bhok kyun raha hai? Mujhe to bhook nahi ke baat hai."
You want to do something about it, do something about it. Why are you coming and barking to me? I am the HOD here, I am managing so many interpolitics and all of these things. A case is not shifted, this is not there. And you come at the end of the day after watching Swadesh and you are like, boss, take it, it's a bam, you know. All of that. You want to do something, you do. I'm like, sir, mera 10,000 rupees ka salary, what do I do? He's like, you know, figure out a way. You've got to do something about it, you do something about it. So I was like, I did have an idea because, you know, when you're facing a problem, what an idea I have. I was thinking, why can't I take a camera, okay, like a digital camera, and figure out a way to connect the digital camera to an existing endoscope, right? Because we have endoscopes, we have 90-degree throatscopes, we have 0-degree earscopes, we have 0-degree nosescopes. You need a viewing system which is very expensive. Why can't a camera which is 8 or 10,000 rupees, so can we connect it there, right? So I thought, let's get a mechanical engineer, and we created a coupler that connects this camera to the endoscope, and we figured out a way to take the light source, right? But this ko banane ke liye paisa chahiye tha, and I didn't have any money because the salary was low.
But I realized we Indian kids are blessed with Indian parents. Who will shell out money if you can at the right frequency wiggle your lower chin? You know, in a very emotional way, thoda sa money nikalo ek answer. Answer to wo thoda main bolay. Toh bola papa, ek project hai. Uske liye 50,000 chahiye. So he said, okay, theek hai, chahiye bachcha. So he gave it to me. And I got this thing made. And when I went to the Mugloor posting this time and actually put the endoscope, I could both see and perceive. Compliance had changed like anything. Because this guy, for the next 3 months, followed up with the medications, kept coming and saying, camera dal ke dikhao mujhe, has it gone or not? And it was a drastic eye-opener for him, till that lesion completely disappeared. Then he took a feeding and he smoked and went. I made a bite, you know. He looked at me, he was very impressed. He was like, yeah, Jagdish, this is so much dumb hair. And then he looked at me and said, you know, if you would have ignored me and not done anything, I would have forgiven you. But now I won't forgive you. He's like, now you take this all into market. And I said, kya baat hai? I'm a VG, main aapke liye unit bana dunga, hum log bad case ko use karenge. Like, what is this? He's like, no, this is a prototype. Isko todte hain, toot jayega, pata nahi kitni baar chalega. Iska battery ka kya source hai, light theek aayega, you know. There is a potential in this. Portable endoscopy has a huge scope. So why don't you make this and take it all the way to market? I'm like, sir, how will I do it as a PG? I don't know how to take a product to market. He's like, I've heard people form startup companies. I'm like, startup company ke kya chahiye? He's like, co-founder. Co-founder chahiye. So I went home, I had a wife. So I looked at her and said, Janim, you're a partner in life. You want to start a company with me? He said, no. So I went to the next best option, her sister. Wo mange. Sali Ali Garwani. So she had done some aeronautic engineering from IIT Madras and she didn't get a job. So she was like, you know, we'll form this company. And I started a company called Yukti Medical Innovations. Two people who had no clue on how to develop devices and take it forward. But my boss did this much that he said, I'll give you 2 months paid leave off. Which basically made me the most wanted enemy in my department. क्योंकि मेरा वो पीजी बोला क्या गेम खेला यार तूने बॉस को पटाते 2 महीने छुट्टी ले ली इनोवेशन इनोवेशन बोल के और तेरा ड्यूटी हम लोग करें एक्स्ट्रा वाले सारे प्रेजेंटेशन एक्स्ट्रा हम करें जर्नल क्लब एक्स्ट्रा हम करें एंड यू नो सो यू ट्रैवल दे डिडंट लाइक इट राइट बट माय बॉस सेड लुक आई गिव यू 2 months ओके एंड आई कनेक्टेड टू एन इंक्यूबेटर और समथिंग ट्राई एंड गेट दिस आउट इन सम वे दैट समवन कैन डेवलप एंड टेक इट ऑल द वे बट इट वाज द वर्स्ट डिसीजन ऑफ माय लाइफ वी हैड नो क्लू how to invent, how to raise money, and how to get a mechanical engineer, how to get a designer, and people were taking us for a ride. Like to make a PCB, one company told us, we have to hire 50,000 rupees per month ki salary, but 3 months tak shayad ban jaye. And whatever money we had raised from some grants or something, we're completely gone and we didn't even get a PCB board made, right? But I had a good design firm that had a heart, and they were willing to help us, and they got us an MSME grant. That would reduce the amount of money for design, and somehow we've put in a few lakhs of our own money. And nobody is willing to invest in us because typically you might think an investor will invest in a technology, which is true, but before that, they invest in the people, right? And if I am a part-time doctor, nobody is going to put their money in, right? Because if I have a lot of money, it's full-time, right? Other time, go duty, case, whatever, very dangerous. Right? So nobody is willing to invest any private money. Government funding was not as good as it is today. And it was very difficult. And I went to Dr. Rabinath and said, sir, look, honestly, I tried my best after 2 minutes of TPL. I appreciate all that. But we don't know how to invent. I can't take this beyond this point, right? And he's like, okay, actually, you'll try it. Okay, I'll clear your thesis and all you do. Just as I was about to leave, he calls me back and says, Jagdish, if you and I don't know how to invent, someone must be knowing how to invent. Like, sir, yes, someone must be there. Why don't you learn from them? Sir, learn man. There must be some fellowship program. Koi na koi to sikha raha hoga. Why don't you learn from them?
Sir, mere ko jaane do.
PG doctor banne hain. Kya kar raha hai yaar?
And he's like, no, I'll clear you, but there's this program called Stanford India Biomedicine, I read about it today, that gives a doctor an opportunity to learn how to invent. You know, you go to AIMS, IIT Delhi, then you go to Stanford University, learn the process with some 2-3 engineers, designers. You get into that program, but there are thesis clear problem. And in 2012, I was, this select only one doctor per year. I got selected with a team in 2012, Dr. Ravina, cleared my thesis, and I cleared from there. But I didn't know what to do with this product, right? So, how many of you have seen Godfather? A few of you have seen Godfather. So, I called the design firm that was developing the product with us. And I gave them an offer they could not refuse. When I called up, I spoke three rooms. Because I'm going to go to Stanford, for my Vegas, and I'm going to go right? So, pata nahi aaunge nahi aaunge, kal hona ho, right? But I don't want this to die in my test. And you guys have understood the technology, you can develop it. I signed a ridiculously small royalty because I just wanted it out. And they thought this is a great way to create their portfolio. And they bought the product from me and I went to Stanford University. So this biodesign program, they take a doctor, engineer, designer, scientist. Okay, four of us go to Stanford, seven oceans away. Right? And we go all the way, and you know the government spends how much per fellow through this program? It's 1 crore per fellow of the funding that the government. Four of us, we reach Stanford University Bay Area, and we go and attend our first session of biodesign. And I get three life eye-opening shocks. The first one was, the whole faculty who was teaching us how to invent were doctors from Indiana with American accents. Raj Devshi, Uday Kumar, Anurag Mehral. I'm like, hum log saath samundar tu se hai. Humko koi Andrew ya Jessica to to yaar. Main wapas ja ke kya bolunga? Bro, Raj Doshi se sikhe. Acha, wo Doshi uncle padho se pehle aap hai. Raj Doshi. Like, there is no dimag. I'm like, why? Itna pura, itna Ravi na. Pura life is flashing front of my eyes. I'm seeing these three Indians. Okay, doctors. One of them is Raj Doshi. I'm like, Dr. Raj, where did you do your MBBS from? Nani Mumbai? Mumbai City MBBS. No, like, the two, three nights I drank, like, just to get this system. And then I'm asking Dr. Raj Doshi, I'm like, Dr. Raj Doshi, how are you as doctors teaching us how to invent? Like, hum log, like, wahi se apne log idhar aake seekh rahe hain, like, mere ko samajh mein nahi aa raha. Oh, he's a cardiologist. I'm like, how did you get into cardiology? He's like, you know, I was a mechanical engineer. I didn't like it, so I became a cardiologist. You what? You didn't like it? You became a cardiologist? Up there, yeah. Cardiologist? Yeah, mechanics. I didn't like the mechanics. I like the heart mechanics. But you bula bhi ho kya reason? I'm like, that's what shock. I'm like, how did you switch? I'm like, you know, it's okay. I don't like it. I like this. I found it more interesting. I mean, how are you doctors teaching us how to invent? Why are we not able to invent there? You are able to invent here? And then he gave me the second most important information. He's like, Jagdish. You know, when you come to a university like Stanford in the Bay Area, and you got an idea that you got to make it a technology, you go to the cafeteria, you can talk to a lawyer, you can talk to an engineer, you can talk to a product designer, you can talk to a model if you like. You can talk to whomever you want, and if your idea really connects, you can form a startup company. And when you form a startup company, Stanford University gives you a sabbatical for 2 or 3 years. You go form your company. And you go down to the Bay Area where there are venture capitalists who will invest money in your technology fund. And then, you know, Stanford gets a payback out of it, and then you can form a company just like Google did. But like the only time I meet an engineer is when he's in the OD table. I'm like, you startup banega tere ko bacha raha hu. Such a scam hai. Number 12. Sharper. You know, because that's the only time we get to see as a doctor, when do you get to see engineers? Events like this are not there, right? And the third most important eye-opening thing is their process of invention is very different. Like, see, as an Indian, I'm a very emotional person. And we do things with a lot of emotion. Because I think the way we invent is like falling in love.
I get poem.
दिमाग में आ जाता है प्रॉब्लम देखा सॉल्यूशन इधर सॉल्व ना नोबेल प्राइज भी मिल गया यू नो एवरीथिंग इज हैपनिंग राइट एंड यू थिंक लाइक दैट बट देयर प्रोसेस इज वेरी डिफरेंट एंड दैट्स व्हाट दे टोल्ड मी दे सेड वी डोंट थिंक ऑफ द आइडिया टिल एज लॉन्ग एज पॉसिबल तो हमने करते क्या हो लाइक हम लोग एक डॉक्टर इंजीनियर डिजाइनर साइंटिस्ट को हॉस्पिटल में भेजते हैं ठीक है टू 2 months, they observe. I'm like, observe? Yeah, just stand like this. They just observe. I said, 2 months. I'm like, kya observe karte? Any problem, anything that went wrong, bleeding zyada hua, hospital stay zyada hua, pay zyada hua, morbidity ho gaya, mortality ho gaya. We note that down. I'm like, you think of the solution? No, no. If you think of the solution, write it somewhere, but don't work on it. Keep understanding the problem. 500 problems, 600 problems. I'm like, now can we think of the solution? No, no. Which is the most important problem? And how do we know? It's like then there is a whole filter sheet. Incidence, prevalence, market requirement, technology, regulatory, go-to-market strategy, buyer, payer, IP, all of that, the scoring karte hain, each and every problem. And when you score that, 10-20 problems come to the top. Because they match all those criteria. I'm like, our idea is what's up? But then I'm like, in 20 mein se kaun se pe kaam karoge? I'm like, ye kaise pata kare? You do due diligence on those 20. Uska pura Bible banta hai. Har ek need ka. 40 page ka document. You go talk to 10 doctors, validate it, do the research. Find out the exact gap and problem in the top 10 problems. I'm like, ab idea? Nahin. Isme se jo top 2-3 hai, which matches your skills. Is it an EMT problem? Is it your product designer's domain expertise? Is it a sensor expertise? Who's matching? So you do brainstorming on the top 5 problems, figure out the solutions that are coming are complementary to your skills, and then you decide. I'm like, hey, Baba, it's very different. You have to first think of the solution so much later. By that time, the solution is obvious. And people are so used to observations when he came back to India that hum log sapna bhi aankhon ke dekhte hain. Observe karte hain. And when we came to Delhi, we observe karte hain. We are observe karte hain. We are observing in AIMS. 2-3 months, we are observing everything. Delhi ke log humse dar gaye. Main hum log sadak pe jaate hain aur ladkiyan bolte hain kya dekh rahe hain? Hum log unmet need hai. पर हमने मार पड़ते कि बाकी लोग उसको ऑब्जर्व करते बट वी इनग्रेड दैट ऑब्जर्वेशन इन टू अस नो नो फॉर ऑब्जर्व करके 500 600 नीड्स एंड देन वी स्टार्ट फिगरिंग आउट ओके दिस प्रोसेस वर्क्स बिकॉज़ वंस यू अंडरस्टूड द प्रॉब्लम यू अंडरस्टूड एवरी डायनामिक ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम द सॉल्यूशन इज वेरी ऑब्वियस टू फिट इट एंड यू हैव अ टीम मोस्ट इंपोर्टेंटली द टीम हैज कम अप विद द आइडिया टुगेदर ओके एंड व्हेन आई केम बैक आई रियलाइज्ड माय फर्स्ट प्रोडक्ट नोबडी इज बाइंग वो डिजाइन फॉर एसे बिल्ड कर रही है such a good product, need a chat today. And then I realized when I put the biodesign process, I understood the flaw that I was making. Think of it, it was very obvious now. I need a portable, low-cost endoscopy device. Who uses endoscopy devices? An ENT surgeon. And the need is in the rural area. How many ENTs are there in rural areas? Not many. So how will an endoscopy high-skilled device be used in the rural area when there is no user for that skill? That was the biggest mismatch, and that's why nobody was willing to buy it. And then when we realized who are the people who work there, they're generally usually general practitioners or pediatricians or you know family medicine. These are the kind of people who are there. They are not skilled in endoscopy. You can't give them a laryngoscope or a otoscope or an nasal endoscope to play around with. Right? So we thought, okay, we thought let us design for the bare minimal skill in rural areas. And we found the bare minimal health provider is a health worker, who is usually a 6-7 standard pass housewife. Right? So we thought let's make it as simple for a health worker to use that anyone above that will easily be able to use it. And we redesigned the whole product to be so simple that a health worker could use. And the moment we did that, a large medtech company called Medtronic bought that technology for us in a direct licensing deal. Because they are looking at screening ear problems in the country to drive the sales of their ear products and then ear surgical devices. And this was a right fit at the right time. The endoscopy tool wouldn't have fit, but the health worker tool was exactly what they wanted. And then that led to my first exit to a large medtech company. And today that product is called Entrepreneur, and it's a part of a Shruti eye care program. And they've screened over 600,000 patients in the whole country, and about 100,000 of them are underwent surgeries. And they, you know, improve from it through this kind of a rural, you know, channelization of products. And that's when I realized this is how the whole process works. It's a team creation first. Like you must have heard, I've been involved in 18 devices over here. But there are only about 8 of them that have made it to the market. 10 have failed. And all 10 failed for the same reason. You know what that same reason is? Can you guess? Sorry?
Product market fit.
Product market, okay, what else? Our team is disintegrated. Chalane wala hi tha. Because sometimes you make a team and you decide that, okay, we are going to work. Now, initially the model used to be doctor gets an idea and we're like, let's find an engineer designer. That engineer designer in his mind is like, I'm making a product for this doctor.
I will get a salary, or I will take a cut, or I will get an equity. But it is never in his mind his product. It is always Dr. Jagdish's product. That model doesn't run for too long. That runs as long as you can pay them, or as long as they see incentive, otherwise they will leave. That is the biggest reason why there was an expectation mismatch with our teams. And you know, they stood for 1 year, 1.5 years, and they're like, this is a very long journey. And some of them went to do MBAs, some of them went back to their old jobs. Some of them said, we probably are not cut for this. They blamed the device, they blamed the technology and the marketing. But at the end of the day, the people who were driving it were not vested in it. And we've seen bad products with good teams do well, and good products with bad teams completely disintegrate. Alright? And that is a very important insight that we learned, that first create a team in a way that everyone finds the need and the idea as their own. Because once you have that ownership, it's very hard to disintegrate. Because then it is not Dr. Jagdish's idea. If all these 8 products have gone into the market, and you look at the patents, and you look at the beneficiaries, it is not only Dr. Jagdish and team. No, it is each and every one has a very sizable role and benefit and insight and incentive to those products. That is why it is running, and that's why Dr. Jagdish can move in from his OPD, OT, spend 8 hours a week, 6 hours a week, go back, because there is a driving force in people to do this because it's their own product. They will not do this for me. They will do this for themselves. And that's why creating the team before the ideation, which is very counterintuitive, is what usually creates successful startup companies. Because then you have a startup company that is invested personally and financially into the idea. And they drive it because that's the risk that they're taking. And once we started doing this, we started creating teams with about 8 startup companies that have come out for each of these 8 products that have raised money, that are commercialized, or that have been exited to large medtech companies, some small medtech companies as well. And that is the reason why that works. Now the question is, how do doctors get in touch with teams beforehand, right? And that's why my new venture is designed to solve that problem. Because I see when we do a cross-section of startup companies, there are about 210 or 230 medtech healthcare startup companies that we have come in direct contact with. Only 7 of them have a doctor embedded in their team. The rest of them have doctors on their slide deck. We have our advisor, unko saal mein ek baar milte hain, chai paani peete hain, bolte product acha, bolte acha kaas. That is the feedback that they get, right? After the product is made. They are not invested in the ideation, they are not invested in the need finding, they are not invested in the feature development, technology, cadaver studies, you know, early benchtop studies. They are there when they're sitting in their office, this team goes and says, sir, your product bana acha hai. Haan, isko thoda na patla kar do, bhai. Is a color they change or something, wo simple hai. You know, those are the kind of feedbacks that they get. Nobody's invested earlier, and that's why most of these needs are not even valid needs. Most of these products don't actually have a huge traction in the market. You require a lot of marketing budget to sell products like these. I'm not saying you can't make this successful. What it takes to make it successful is extremely unreasonable in terms of time, money and cost. If you want something to go very quickly, it has to have a strong pull for a need. Then with less money, budget and marketing, you can get that product out of the market. But having said that, you can get any product successful. Have you heard of this app called Yo? You heard of this app called Yo? It is a very interesting thing. You can find anybody and send Yo. And when they receive your Yo, they can send the Yo back to you. Valued at $10 million, by Series A from the Bay Area. And the reason why this worked is because the co-founders did not leave that idea, whatever it was, I don't know if it's an idea, for 5 years. They put $2 million to get 2 million users. And when they got 2 million users, they went to the next round of investors and said, we have 2 million users. They're like, oh, that's amazing.
This sounds like a real idea. There are 2 million users doing Yo.
Seeing that another company made an app called Bro, they have raised $5 million. You know, it depends on what it takes to get anything like Yo successful. And every time I'm depressed about my technology, I'll be like, Yo, and Yo is valued at $10 million. This is at least a life-saving technology. We just don't have the money and the bandwidth to do what they were able to do for you. But if you can do it at 1/10, it's still possible. Right? So we created an app called Hi, H-triple-I-H. It's a very simple story. We wanted to call it Hi, but we didn't get the domain name.
Sir, Bandhi for Hi.
Yeah, that's it. So we called it H-I, we didn't get domain, then we made it H-I-I, we didn't get domain, then we had put H-I-I-I, we didn't get domain. Then we started adding H. And then at H, IIIH, we got the domain. Then I worked in the government for 2 years, so I figured out acronym management. And I figured out that the acronym is Healthcare Innovation. innovation in Indian healthcare. Because we want, when anybody calls us app, we should call it high. Because it's a greeting platform for doctors to connect with engineers, designers, investors, hospitals, startup companies. We have about 209 startup companies registered. We have about 800 people, out of which 300 are doctors, who are interested in innovations. And you can download it from Google and the app, Apple iOS store, called HIIH. And you can find anyone in your co-location. You know, it's basically a bit of Uber, Tinder, LinkedIn match, but specifically made for healthcare innovations. And mainly designed to get doctors connecting with these people before they can do idea generation. The idea is they connect early, and then they work together to identify the problem, maybe in a specific domain area, form startup companies. And then there is this app is free, but we put some services which are startup friendly. Need validation services, biodesign training services, paper writing, getting grants, grant writing, or getting quick clinical trials, focus group discussions, which startups can buy, and that's a revenue model to sustain. But otherwise, it's free to use and find people, and there are some pretty solid people on that portal, right from high-end distributors, marketing salespeople, to investors, large medtech company players, small medtech company players, and 300 doctors who want to work full-time as co-founders. And that's a new venture that I've worked on, and the rest of the time, I do stand-up comedy to maintain backup carriers. I was a professor and I'll largely perform for the medical community. Also coming up with a web series called Starting Troubles, which is going to be the first medical humor web series designed on a PG life in India. But having said these things, I want to leave with a small note. After I started developing these devices, Dr. Ravi Nair, he's now the dean of HCG Cancer Hospital in Bangalore. He called me and said, "Jagdish, give a talk to my doctors about how to invent." And I gave a talk and they were found it very useful. They're like, "These are things we did not know." And I thought, okay, now Dr. Ravi Nair is patting on my back. I did a slow back moonwalk. And he looked at me and was like, "Jagdish, talk again, walk around. Kya baat karo, sir? Products bana rahe hain, I'm balancing two, three things to do. Yeah, but you are barking about it. Kitne chale jaake bolega? There are lakhs of doctors, many medical colleges. Har jagah jaake bolega, bhonkta rahega. That's what you will do. I'm like, what should I do, sir, to impress you? What do you think is the way to fight?" He's like, "Write it in a book." And that's why I wrote it in a book. I wrote a book called Inventing Medical Devices, A Perspective from India, 2 years ago, only for one purpose, is to impress Dr. Ravi Nair. I wrote some very close to success in him. He said something that really changed my approach. He's like, "Jagdish, don't wait for success to write about it, because sometimes success can take so long that by the time someone reads about it, it's outdated. Write about the failures you're facing now. Someone in that same mode might change their decision and track by reading about your failures, and you are a ustad in failure." Right? मैंने बोला failure की story की कमी नहीं है. मैंने 10 product failures उसमें डाल दी थी. हमने ये किया, ये IP flaw हो गया, ये वो हो गया. And I put it out and I sent a link to Dr. Ravi Nair, and he's like, "Yeah, this is the first time you made a point." But that book sold 10,000 copies in 1 month. And I started getting messages saying, "Is my both formatting issues here? My spelling page number 8 mein galat hai." I bola, "Ye tumhare padhne ke liye nahi nikala hai. Ye insaan ke liye nikala hai. Maine khud ki shanti ke liye." But they realized there is no Indian medical device book in the country. And anyone who's trying to invent and searches medical devices, that book used to pop up. And people started ordering it and buying it. I had to recall all the copies, get a formal publisher, republish that book, make it look decent, remove all the spelling mistakes. And now it's available on stores and this thing called Inventing Medical Devices Perspective from India, written for doctors on how to invent step by step. So if you get a chance, please do read it. Otherwise, thank you very much for this opportunity.